Glad to see you made it back in one piece, Velvet.
I'm here on orders from the boss to help you guys out.
We could certainly use it. How are things back in the city?
I came here from Helleviz, so I don't know how far the suppression has progressed. But I can tell you that the Abbeys designated the area north of Helleviz as a Class 4 administrative zone.
Which means they've pulled their forces out of the area.
What about the people of Mercio?
Everyone got out safe and sound, although they did petition for the extermination of the Lord of Calamity.
Of course.
I say we make this town our new hideout. When else are we ever gonna find a hideout that comes with hot springs?
That's a good idea. We should leave Kamoana and the others here.
Dial, could you stay and help them out?
As if you even had to ask.
Wow, that's surprisingly reliable for you, Dial.
Hey, that hurts. Now get going already. Benwick and the crew are making preparations in Helleviz right now.
Grimoire, could we talk?
You sound so serious, like it's the eve of the final battle.
Well, isn't it? Can't you let yourself get caught up in the moment for a change?
Getting caught up in the moment is for young, foolhardy lovers. So, what is it you want to talk about?
I just figured I should drop by since, well, like I said, the final battle with the Nominat is coming up and all.
Ugh, you're talking like you're saying your last goodbyes.
It's just that we're up against a lot. Even Miss Mogilu doesn't know what the future holds for us, and she almost always has that stuff figured out.
Whether she has it figured out or not, it is our lot in life to follow our vessels and fight to the very end.
That's what I've always thought, so I just dealt with Miss Mogilu's craziness up till now. But she's never thanked me for it! No, good job, Bianfu! No, I'm glad I'm your vessel! Not even something like, I'll introduce you to a cute girl when it's all over! It'd be nice to hear a little gratitude from her, even just once.
Surely you know she's not the type to do that sort of thing, though, yes?
That's all the more reason to want just one brief glimpse at who she is underneath.
If you're so unhappy, it's not too late to switch back to the Abbey's side and become an informant again.
What's the point in that? I don't know anything they'd want, and they wouldn't have any use for me there.
So you lack confidence in your own abilities?
Miss Moggy Lou has let me come with her wherever she went, and her talents have gotten us this far. But now that we have to fight Enominat, I'm worried. I don't know what use I can be for her, or if I can keep her safe.
But you'll still go, won't you?
Yeah, of course! Or else my name isn't Norman Brave!
See, you can do this. You've been keeping Moggy Lou safe this whole time. With all the emotional pain she's been through, she's needed someone as thick-skinned and tenacious as you. She may talk like she doesn't care, but she wouldn't have tracked you down and renewed your pact if she didn't.
When you put it like that, bien! All right, you've convinced me!
That's right. You just trust in old Norman therapist's good advice. It won't steer you wrong.
Wow! I'd have never expected you to actually make a joke like that, Grimoire!
I just thought I'd get caught up in the moment like you wanted.
There, Exorcist! Do you know what happened to the Praetor, Lady Teresa? She used to be in charge here. Lady Teresa is the only one who can restore law and order in our town. Please, send a message to the Abbey. Tell them that the citizens of Hellevise are awaiting her return. Even if the Lord of Calamity herself were to attack, I won't budge until Lady Teresa returns to us.
What will refusing to move accomplish?
If my life is in danger, I know Lady Teresa will come to save me. Her, and that ice-cold glare of hers.
Teresa won't be coming back.
What?
If you really love Teresa, you shouldn't rely on her to protect you. You should become strong enough to protect her.
Whoa, that burning glare of yours. I think I like it.
Wait, what?
Planning evacuation routes. We need to be ready if the Calamity or demons show up in town.
When the Calamity attacked the first time, there was massive confusion. Some children got hurt in all the madness. We're preparing evacuation boats so that we can all flee out to the sea if anything happens.
It's a good idea, but it will be hard to evacuate the entire town by boat. You'd best prepare a land route, too.
That's a good point. But wouldn't a land route run the risk of being attacked by demons?
Yes. You'll need to guard it as heavily as you do the city gates. It would be best if you could devise a way to prevent demons from intercepting the escape route, but...
Some of the exorcists lost use of their malachim. We can't count on the Abbey's garrison to help us.
I'll send a request for aid to the Abbey. But please, don't give up. Try to think of something.
Of course. There's no way we'll give up. You can't rely on someone else to protect you.
Can you really ask the Abbey for help?
I can send a Silvche to some of my old friends from when I was still in training. Even if they refuse to trust a traitor like me, they won't ignore the plight of the people here in Hellevise.
Nyfried's crew can...
How long are you going to sit there crying? You can't be a fisherman if you're afraid of some Lord of Calamity.
The demons that wrecked this town are still alive. Who knows when they'll show up again?
How about right now?
Sniveling idiot! Keep whining like that, and this Calamity whatever will keep walking all over you!
But what can we do? We can't even defeat a single demon.
That's why we take our boats, catch some fish, and make sure we've got enough food to keep on surviving. Didn't they drill anything into that fool head of yours in school? Ugh. Do I have to knock some sense into you? Get up and get the boat ready!
That is one hot-headed dad.
Too hot for any demons to get near, that's for sure.
Welcome back! I take it you defeated the Legates.
Yes, but that still leaves Enominat and the Shepherd.
Onward ho to the last battle! Oh, I picked up something nice for you. Here.
An apple?
It's a fortune apple. A good luck charm. No real powers, but they're hard to find. Legend has it, they're pretty lucky.
A fortune apple!
But we're the bad guys, aren't we? Maybe what we need is bad luck instead.
I think the Reaper's got that covered.
Aw, that's just mean.
Well, I appreciate the thought. Thanks, Benwick. I love apples.
Just don't eat it!
I couldn't eat it, even if I wanted. Wait a moment. That's right. My power to consume is a part of Enominat. If that's true, then...
What is it?
You want a bite? Delicious fortune apple.
No way! That's a good luck charm!
That it is. One to give you the courage you need to survive.
So, where's our final destination?
The Empyrean's throne.
Sail for Port Zexon.
Aye aye, ma'am. Aye aye, sir.
Just...
Do you think that with Enominat's power waning, people will be free again?
Well, the pirates are acting like pirates again. May take longer for others, but I think it's happening.
What do you think of traveling around to see for ourselves? I'd like to know what's going on out there.
I'd like to meet the Elemental Empyreans, if I could.
That's not a great idea. They're all in various Earth Pulse points, but where those are is a mystery. They could be very far off.
And they might not view us as allies.
Yep, gods live by their own rules. Our business with Enominat probably doesn't concern them.
You're right.
It might be wise to scope out the situation before our battle. As we go around, we might find out more about what Artorias is up to.
Hey, Rokuro! I heard about a Class 4 island that sounds damn near perfect for you.
An island that's perfect for me. Do the rivers flow with good drink?
Now that you mention it. But no, different island. I'm talking about you as a swordsman. The demons there all run around the island in suits of armor and helmets and stuff, I hear.
Armored demons are not unusual.
Yeah, but what I heard tell was that all the exorcists who got sent there came back with their swords broken. I don't know if they've got swords too, or if their armor is just that strong, but I reckon your sword will be able to stand up to them.
Well then, I've heard worse ideas.
If you believe the tales, that island used to be a place where swordsmen and knights competed to see who was stronger.
Oh yeah, I know the island you're talking about. Craftsmen from all over gave their finest weapons and armor to the greatest of warriors and made them fight. It was as much a showcase for those wares as it was a contest of strength.
So the demons on that island might come at us wielding fine arms and armor.
I'm certainly up for checking it out. I'm curious to see how good the stuff really is.
After all I've told you, you still want to go? What is wrong with you?
So, what was it you needed to say to me alone?
Where's Lafayette?
He wanted to stand watch with me, but I forced him to get some rest. After all this fighting, he needs it.
I owe you. That kid always tries to play the tough guy.
Just like the one who named him.
He's nothing like me. His motivation comes from hope.
Hope.
The wind is nice.
Yes, the world may teem with hardship and sadness, but it's also filled with beauty. The endless ocean, the islands in the south, even the frozen tundra and the mountains that spew fire.
It is. And humans make their home among all that beauty. This is the world that Lafi always yearned to travel. I finally understand what he saw when he sat looking out over the ocean. Eleanor, I have a single favor to ask of you. If anything happens to me, take care of Lafayette.
What? Is something the matter?
The power possessed by the Therians and Innominaut is fundamentally the same. I have a theory. No, theory is too rational. A different part of me, something separate from my hatred, wants me to do something. It wants me to leave this world with hope.
Wait, you don't mean...
Humor me, okay? If the worst happens, I'm counting on you.
I understand. You have my word. I'll look after Lafayette. While I'd love to take advantage of this momentary weakness, I can't. My oath is to obey your orders until my dying breath.
I'd almost forgotten about all that. Good thing I kicked your butt after all. Well, the suppression field is gone.
And in its place, rampaging demons.
We expected that. Thanks for everything.
I only did what I felt like doing. Who needs thanks for that?
Let's go. We have a fight to finish with the Shepherd.
Innominaut's power may have weakened, but I think that'll only cause more of a stir in the cities.
Without the Abbey's exorcists, the people will have a hard time quelling demons.
Are you crying?
I'm simply coming to terms with reality. I've learned to think for myself rather than let others do the thinking for me. It's painful and frightening, and comes with great responsibility. But this is who I am now. It's on me to own up, face my fears, and keep moving forward.
You're a piece of work. But I don't mind having you around.
Yes. I'm not weak like I used to be.
No, you aren't.
You don't have to bear the weight of the world alone, though.
I understand that. I will do only what I can.
You always say that, but then you end up overdoing it, right? If you push yourself to the limit and it's still not enough, there's no shame in relying on others.
Rokuro, thank you so much.
You realize you just thanked a demon, right?
I'm aware of that.
We put all our faith in you because you said you could protect us. We endured all your harsh rules and laws.
So how can you tell us you can't defeat the demons because you can't control Malakim anymore?
We don't understand why we've lost the ability to control our Malakim. But even without my Malak arts, I will fight to my dying breath to protect all of you. So please, calm down.
I'm not listening to anything the Abbey says anymore.
What are you looking at? Yeah, you there. Mean-looking guy. Get over here.
I think I'll pass. Thanks.
Hey, Muscles! Get back here! I'm not through with you!
Please stop. I understand that you're worried and upset, but now isn't the time to be fighting amongst ourselves. Please, let us all stand together. Help us fight off the madness and the demons that threaten our world. And if that's not good enough for you, you can face me instead.
Guess I'm sorry.
That exorcist has some serious backbone.
Aye.
Hey, it's you! Mogilu's Debauchery.
It's Menagerie.
I finally get a chance to see the famous Mogilu's Menagerie. I've been waiting forever to meet up with you again.
Meet up with us? Why?
Well, with my bad luck, I've always just missed out on seeing your splendiferous performances. So, well, I made my own menagerie. The Abbey is a mess, and people everywhere are scared. Demons abound, and... well, everyone's so gloomy. So I thought that this is exactly the time when people need something fun and happy to lift their spirits. My troop is still in training, but we're almost ready.
That's wonderful. What do you call yourselves?
I wanted something with power, impact. So behold, we are the Dark Wings.
Dark Wings. Huh.
Hey, what gives? That's a terrible reaction.
You're trying to cheer people up, right? So why dark? And dark wings only make me picture crows. Or bats, maybe.
Really? When I think of the Dark Wings, I think comedy. Maybe I should rethink this. Oh, I got it! We'll be the Dark Smiles!
Sounds like you've got a pretty dark sense of humor. You really want to go with such a dark-hearted name?
Okay, fine. The Dark Magic. No, the Dark Circus! No, that's no good. The darkest hour! The dark...
Maybe you could try losing the dark part.
Good point. All right, then. How about this one? The Peddlers of Joy!
We don't accept solicitations.
Fine. Forget you. I've made my decision. We're Darkwing Menagerie of Comedy, and that's final.
He really went all out. Still, you've got zing, kid. Here's hoping you have many dark years to come. Magikazam!
Thanks! That makes us rivals now, but still, from one entertainer to another, good luck!
About that Magikazam of yours, you only use that spell when you couldn't care less what happens, right?
What this world needs now is a good dose of apathy. Am I right?
But here's hoping you have many dark years to come. That's not very nice at all, is it?
Magic Kazam!
I can't get my hands on nectar or a good drink anymore, but thanks to that, I've finally seen the light. I tried drinking lots of different things to help cope with my cravings, and I discovered that a nice cup of tea really does the trick. You can't give kids the heavy stuff, but tea? Kids, adults, the elderly? Everyone can enjoy it.
That's a good positive point of view.
I'm thinking about using my life savings to open a tea shop filled with tea from all over the world. Rather than let ourselves get all worked up panicking over the demons, we'd be better off sitting down with a nice cup of relaxing tea.
It'd be wonderful if you sold some tasty pies or cookies there, too.
I know, right? I need to find some baked goods that go well with tea. Maybe I can find a girlfriend while I'm at it.
Well, good luck with that.
Thanks. Speaking of which, are you single?
Sorry, think I'll pass.
Yeah, figured as much.
I can feel him. Inominat's somewhere in the sky.
In the sky?
Wait, look!
You're the ones who liberated us from Inominat's domain, right? I want to thank you for all that you've done.
You really don't have to do that. I was just acting in my own interests. If any Malakims still get in my way, I won't hesitate to devour them.
Hey, hold up! Most of us are under the influence of Enominat's power and have been robbed of our free will.
The majority of Malakim are too afraid of malevolence to even go near humans. Before Enominat's interference, we were a peaceful people.
That doesn't matter to me.
We get what you're saying. But if we go easy on anybody, then we'll be the ones who get killed. If you truly want to protect your friends, you'll have to stop us by force.
Wouldn't you agree that having free will means choosing the path you believe in?
I suppose you're right. And that's why we too will work toward the future we desire.
In order to achieve a perfect fusion of human and Malak power, the Abbey gave Armadi a physical form. Specifically, their vessels embedded with a formula that can manipulate mana. They call these objects divine artifacts.
Is that what that bow is?
Yes, this is one of the divine artifacts. We've decided we want to pass on the knowledge behind the divine artifacts and armatization to future generations.
Why would you want to do that? Armatization is dangerous.
We want to enable humans and Malakim to coexist.
What?
In its current form, armatization is a one-sided process, allowing a human to exploit a Malak's power. But imagine if humans and Malakim could armatize with mutual awareness and consent.
It could provide just the edge our people need to battle the great forces who seek to harm our world.
Like the Lord of Calamity, you mean? Well, do what you want.
It's another potential for the future.
Yes.
But I have one warning for you. The divine artifact intended for Enominat is already complete. You know what that means, don't you?
Artorias himself will use the divine artifact to armatize with Enominat.
For the good of the future, we'll pray for your success in battle, Lord of Calamity.
Okay. Well, it's nice that we've tracked down Enominat, but now what's the plan?
I don't think even Griffin could get us up there. And my guardian takes one passenger only.
I don't think we need to worry about that.
Huh? Well, looky there. A teleportation art. Looks like we're expected.
For Enominat to fully awaken, they need me and Lafayette. Which means they want to settle this once and for all, too.
Sounds good to me! Bring it on! Is what reckless idiots say before plunging into the unknown. Be more cautious. Sorry.
Wow. That is the first time I've ever heard Magilu say something sensible.
A bad omen. Let's be careful and take a good look around first.
Belittling a faithful ally right before the final showdown? Do you not cry? If I prick you, do you not bleed?